Good morning, everyone. Today we will discuss about scientific terms. Yes. So first of all, there is a term magnetic substances. Magnetic substances are those substances which are attracted towards the magnet. Yes, those substances which attracted towards the magnet, they are known as magnetic substances. Like your iron is there, cobalt is there, nickel is there. Okay, so these are the magnetic substances. And on the other hand, non-magnetic substances are those substances which are not attracted by the magnet. Like your wood is there, plastic is there. Okay, so magnetic substances, those which are attracted by the magnet. And non-magnetic substances are those which are not attracted by the magnet. Now the question is there, what is magnet? What is a magnet? A magnet is that, a magnet is a substance which attracts iron towards them. So any substance which attracts iron towards them, that is a magnet. And magnet is of two types, natural magnet as well as artificial magnet. Natural as well as artificial. And the word magnet is taken by a word, it is the magnetite. Magnetite is an ore of magnet. Now the next one is your magnetic compass. The next term is your magnetic compass. As the name indicates, the compass which is used to find the direction. Yes, it is a property of a magnet. A freely suspended magnet always aligned in north and south direction. So magnetic compass is a device that is used to find directions. Now our next term is electric switch. Yes, electric switch. What is a switch? A switch is a device. A switch is a device which is used to on and off the electricity. Yes, to on and off the electric power, the electricity, the electric switch is used. Now, if we will talking about the electric circuit means path of electricity. It is a path of electricity. Through this path, electricity flow from one terminal to next terminal. And can you tell me what is the path of electricity? Yes, electricity always flow from positive terminal to negative terminal. This is a path of electricity. So electric circuit is a path on which the electricity can flow. And electric switch is a device which is used to on and off the electric current. Now conductors and insulators. Conductors and insulators. So conductors are those substances, those objects which allow electricity to pass through them. So those substances through which electricity can pass, these are known as conductors. For example, here your copper is there, aluminium is there. So these are the conductor. Human body is a conductor of electricity. Water is a conductor of electricity. Now insulators are those substances which do not allow electric current to pass through them. Yes. For example, your plastic is there, wood is there. These are the examples of insulators. Air is an insulator of electricity because you see ki if there is any gap between the electric circuit, between the wires, the electricity will not flow. Means air act as an insulator. So these are the different terms we had discussed. I think all of you had understand well. Now, we will discuss about poles of a magnet. Yes, we will discuss about poles of a magnet. What is a magnet? Yes, magnet is any object which attracts iron, nickel, cobalt towards it. So, any object which attracts iron towards us, that is a magnet. And if we will talking about the magnet, each and every piece of magnet, even a small piece of magnet, it has two poles. So how many poles of a magnet? There are always two poles of a magnet, north pole and south pole. So and the maximum attraction power, the maximum attraction power of a magnet at their poles. So let us find out. So we can just do it. We can just find out in a very easy way. Just take a mixture of iron filings and sand. Take a mixture of iron filings and sand. Now take a piece of magnet and just you can say take a piece of magnet and just take it the piece of magnet near to that mixture. You can say that the most of the iron filling that get attract towards the sides of the magnet means at the north pole as well as on the south pole. So this activity proved that the maximum attraction power of magnet is at their poles. Now how you can find out ki which is the north pole and which is the south pole of a magnet? Again, we can do it in a proper way and in a very easy way. Just take a piece of a magnet and tie it with the help of a thread. Okay, now just rotate it freely. Rotate it and when it comes to rest, it always comes to rest in north and south direction. Means one end of the magnet faces towards the north and one end of the magnet faces towards the south. So that portion, which end faces towards the north of the earth, that is your north pole or the north seeking end of the magnet. And that face which faces towards the that part which faces towards the south direction, that is your south pole or the south seeking poles of a magnet. So there are two poles of a magnet, north pole and south pole, and the maximum attraction power of a magnet is at their poles. As we had discussed earlier, There are two poles of a magnet, north pole and south pole. Do you know that the same poles repel each other and the different poles attract each other? Yes, that is a property of a magnet. Same poles repel each other, they moving apart from each other, and the different poles attract each other means they come together for each other. So let us find out. So we have two magnets and we are facing the north pole of one magnet to the north pole of another magnet. So what do you think? Which process is going on? They will come too near to each other or they will move away from each other? Yes, you are right. They move away from each other means they are the same poles. The same poles repel each other. Now, there are again two magnets and the north pole of one magnet facing towards the south pole of another magnet. So when it's that situation is there, what do you think? They will attract each other or they repel each other? Yes, they will attract each other means they will come closer to each other. Now there is another pair of a magnet and one south pole of one magnet facing towards the north pole of another magnet. So naturally they are the different poles, north pole and south pole, south pole and north pole. So they will come closer to each other and they attract towards them. Now we have the two magnets with they are facing the same poles, the same south poles towards each other. So what do you think? What will happen? Yes, you are right. They will move apart from each other means there is a process of repulsion. So if I will asking from you ki in which situation two magnets repel each other? Yes, if there are north and north pole facing each other or if there are south and south pole facing each other. And in which situation they attract each other? Yes, you are right. When the north pole facing the south or the south pole facing the north. So this activity proved that there are two poles of a magnet and the same poles repel and the different poles attract each other. we will discuss about properties of a magnet. Yes, properties of a magnet. As you know, magnet is a substance which attract iron towards it, and there are two types of magnet: natural magnet and artificial magnet. Artificial magnets available in different shapes, like the horseshoe magnet is there, bar magnet is there. Now, when we're talking about properties of a magnet, the first one, each magnet has two magnetic poles. Yes, each magnet has two magnetic poles. One is the north pole and one is the south pole. As we have discussed earlier, the north pole means the end of the magnet which seeking towards the north side, that is the north pole, and the end of the magnet which seeking towards the south side, that is the south pole. So each magnet has two magnetic poles, north pole and south pole. Now the next property is there, a freely suspended magnet. Means if we will have a magnet and if we will tie it with the help of a thread, so it can freely move. A freely suspended magnet always align in north and south direction. Means if we will have a piece of magnet tied with the thread and we will move it, it always comes to and rest in north and south direction. One side faces towards the north and one side faces towards the south. So a freely suspended magnet always align in north and south direction. Now the next property of a magnet is that the opposite poles of a magnet. If there are two opposite poles of a magnet faces to each other, they attract each other. You can see there are two magnets, magnet A and magnet B. When we face the different poles of the magnet to each other, they start attracting each other. They start coming closer to each other. So that is the property of a magnet, that opposite poles of two magnets attract each other. Now the next one, the similar poles, like the north pole and north pole, or like the south pole and the south pole, similar poles of two magnets repel each other. In the same way, you can see there are two magnets, magnet A and magnet B. And when we just try to put together the same poles, north pole and north pole, we are not able to do because they are moving apart from each other. So these are the properties of a magnet. The first one, each magnet has two magnetic poles, north pole and south pole. Second, a freely suspended magnet always aligns in north and south direction. Next, opposite poles of two magnets attract each other and the similar poles of two magnets repel each other. Now we will discuss about precautions which we should take to keep our magnet safe. Okay, so let us discuss. So first of all, we should try to find out the reasons due to which magnets loses their properties. Okay. So, a single magnet, or you can say magnets, lose their properties if they are heated, if they are hammered, or if they are dropped from a height. So, these are the reasons due to which a magnet can lose their attraction power. So, a magnet should not be heated, should not be hammered, or should not be dropped from a height. So these are the precautions. If we will want that our magnets will lifelong for a longer time, so we should take that precautions. Next one, a magnet becomes weak. Become weak means it loses its attraction power. So a magnet becomes weak if it is not stored properly. So we should keep our magnets, we should store our magnet in a proper way in a magnetic keeper. So let us try to find out ki what we can do. For example, if we have a bar magnet. If we have a bar magnet should be kept in pairs. A bar magnet should be kept in pairs. And how do we save them? How we can put them into a magnetic keeper? By unlike poles on the same side. Means we will just write down, we will put it into our pairs, into a box with the unlike poles on the same side, and it is the these two magnets are should be separated by a piece of wood. It should be separated by a piece of wood. In the same way, if you have the horseshoe magnet, then the horseshoe and magnet, the poles, the different poles of the horseshoe magnet should be separated by a piece of iron. So a magnet, when we have a magnet, we should keep them safely in a box, in a magnetic keeper, in pairs, and by dividing them with a piece of wood or a piece of iron. A magnet also becomes weak if it is not stored properly, or if it is we will put it nearby to any electronic item, like the TV is there, CD is there, music system is there, computer is there. So we should keep the magnets away from the TV, CDs, music system and computer, etc. So if we will take care of that, then we can keep our magnet for a long time.